Welcome back to another Infinite Flight tutorial. In this video, I'll show you how to properly manage your descent on Infinite Flight, from using the various methods to calculate your descent to interacting with ATC. We've taken off from San Francisco, climbed a cruise, enjoyed some views, but now what? As I approach Centers Airspace on my arrival into Portland International, we'll begin by reviewing the latest airport information and calculating our descent. I first tap on the airport icon where I can review the DATIS, or Digital ATIS. This is a full ATIS broadcast like you're used to hearing, but in text form, allowing you to check further out from the field, all while never leaving frequency of communicating with ATC. The DATIS contains runway in use along with the preferred stars, which I can verify that I've filed. If you're not sure, you can also tap the Procedures tab, which indicates the ATC preferred arrivals into Portland. We filed the Timbers 2 arrival, which fully complies with the ATC pref routes. Next, let's calculate our top of descent. The first method I'll show you involves two manual calculations, one for distance and the other for the correct rate of descent. At 38,000 feet, our first altitude restriction is 24,000 feet at Moxie, which means we have 14,000 feet to lose. Altitude to lose divided by 1,000 times 3 equals the distance from Moxie we need to begin descending, so 14,000 feet divided by 1,000 times 3 gives us 42 miles from Moxie. Next, we'll take our ground speed and multiply by 5 to determine the rate of descent. At 433 knots ground speed times 5, that gives us 2,165 feet per minute, which will round up to 2,200. With our final planning and calculations complete, we'll check in with the center controller for Portland International. Center's airspace is defined by the bold white boundary we're approaching on our map, and I'll show you their vertical airspace now. In order to continue following my flight plan, I will select Check In on my ATC comms menu. The response radar contact will allow us to continue following our flight plan, though it's important to note that altitude changes should be requested unless given approval to descend via a published star. If you do not have a filed star in your flight plan, you'll receive ATC assigned headings and altitudes when it's time to descend, or you may be asked to amend your flight plan to include an ATC preferred star. As we approach our top of descent, it's time to make our request to descend via the Timbers 2 arrival. We previously calculated that we need to descend 42 miles before Moxie. The leg from Aaron to Moxie is 45 miles, so I'll request about 1 minute prior to descent as we approach Aaron. Remember, never set VNAV until you're approved to descend with ATC, or you're able to monitor your entire descent. As I approach 42 miles from Moxie, I'll request to descend via the Timbers 2 arrival, setting 24,000 feet in my autopilot and a 2,200 feet per minute descent, which we previously calculated. Let's talk about our second descent tool, the altitude arc, commonly referred to as the banana. Based on our current speed, altitude, and rate of descent, the banana will indicate on the map where we'll reach the set altitude. With this reference, we can increase or decrease our rate of descent. I've increased my rate of descent slightly until the arc is resting directly on Moxie, which tells me I'll cross it at 24,000 feet. Another great way to verify is using our previous calculation to determine distance. This can be done multiple times during your descent to determine if you're high or low on your descent profile. As we approach 34,000 feet, we'll have 10,000 feet to lose, and the calculation tells me that I need 30 miles to meet Moxie's altitude restriction, which is spot on with where we're at currently. The third and final method of descending we'll use is VNAV. Check out our tutorial on VNAV for a more in-depth explanation. While descending based on our manual calculation, we verified with the altitude arc and can now select VNAV to let the autopilot do the rest of the work. At any time on your arrival, ATC may assign an alternate heading or altitude for traffic. This requires me to disarm VNAV, LNAV, and enter the assigned heading and altitude manually. Once traffic is no longer a factor, ATC may instruct you to continue as filed. This means we can resume our flight plan and previous altitude restrictions defined by the star. With a quick activation of the appropriate leg in our flight plan, LNAV and VNAV were back on our way. As I descend through flight level 190, I'm coming up on Approaches airspace, which begins at flight level 180 and below. We've received a handoff from center, we'll tune in and make our initial request. Your first request with Approach should always be your Approach request, not a check-in. We've been told to continuous filed and expect the ILS for runway 28 left. Continuous filed allows us to continue on our flight plan and previously approved descent via. You may also hear to expect vectors, which means ATC will provide all headings and altitudes. As we approach the flower waypoint, let's review our descent methods one last time. Using the manual calculation, we have 9,000 feet to lose, which means we should be descending 30 miles from flower. Check. Next, the altitude arc says we'll cross at 9,000 feet based on our current altitude and speed. I also double-checked my VNAV, method 3, and has captured 9,000 feet with an appropriate descent rate. As you get closer to your destination, you can expect Approach to begin vectoring you for your requested approach. In this case, we've been given a right turn and our final descent onto the base leg for runway 28 left. Knowing I won't be following my flight plan anymore, I'll go ahead and disarm the LNAV, VNAV, and change my navigation source to begin tracking the 28 left ILS in anticipation of my approach clearance. The rest is all familiar to you. With a normal ILS approach, landing, and taxi to the gate, this completes another on-time arrival. If you found this helpful, be sure you subscribe to the channel for more. You can also check out our flying guide at infiniteflight.com for the most in-depth information. And of course, follow us on social media at Infinite Flight. I'll see you next time.